Hello, everyone. My name is Tim B. Green, and this is Crush-It.Club, Episode 8. So we do this right. Successive approximation. Okay, successive approximation is a fancy word that scientists and other geeks like to use to make themselves sound smarter. Great analogy, though, which pretty much any kid, maybe not kids today, but any kid who was a kid who's my age, somebody who's my age now, 54, we used to have a game we liked to play called Battleship. I don't know if it's still popular, which is why I mentioned the kids' age. So pretty basic game, right? You shoot. So let's say right here. Okay. B6. Miss. Next round, the other person, then it's your turn again. A5, hit. Well, of course, it's not really rocket science from here on out, right? You know, either the ship is running this way, so you should shoot here, or the ship is running this way, and you should shoot either A6 or A4 to make your next shot, right? So this is the essence of a successive approximation, right? It's also the essence of Kaizen, whether people like to think of it that way or not, right? Kaizen is to make incremental improvements, but really what it is it's about continuous improvement. So continuous improvement on hitting your target is what this game Battleship is about. So it's the same thing. It's also the same as iterative innovation or rapid prototyping, right? You make your prototype, you look at the prototype, you see if it works properly, and if it doesn't, you learn from the real world, empirically derived information you get from actually making the prototype instead of staying in the planning forever phase. Now, where this is essential for the average Joe, for anybody who wants to do anything in their life, is a lot less about this fancy verbiage or Kaizen or anything else. It's just to spend a whole lot more time taking action rather than planning to take action. One of the biggest fundamental problems with SMART goals, which I have a nice article called SMART Goals Are Stupid, because they are. And the reason they're stupid is because they have really two reasons, but there's redundancy in that to be attainable and to be realistic is to be the same thing. You can't be unattainable and realistic, and you can't be unrealistic and attainable. So one of those can go, and you can spell it like Homer Simpson, SMRT, I am so smart. So that's sort of my approach to that. But really the whole point of that is that you can, as long as you know your destination and you know your immediate next step, right, where to shoot next, that's all you need to know. And as you shoot next, so if you shoot and get A6 and then your opponent says hit, now you either know you're going to go to A7 or A4. So that's the successive approximation. If you go, okay, I did A5, so this time I'm going to do B5, and they go miss, well, then you know not to shoot there again. So you've got two misses here, one hit here. So this ship now, you know, has to be going this direction. You don't know whether it goes here, here, and here, or exactly like it is, or goes down here, but you know you don't need to shoot anymore in column B, right? So pretty simple stuff, but yet, especially when it comes to things like SMART goals, I have a list which uses a checklist that I'm going to be releasing soon. I need to get the web page stuff done, which I'm really pretty inexperienced at. So lots of iterations going on there to get it right. But I'll be releasing that, and I will post a way to get that soon. So, but the thing is, it's about maximizing action in small increments, in small iterations, to produce results which you can then use to adjust your shots, adjust your trajectory, your direction that you're going in. So to do that, really all you need is your next action and your final destination. Exactly how long it's going to take you to do that. Now, this is a great reason to use this analogy again. And that is, well, you don't know, because until you shoot there, if you shoot there and it doesn't work, okay, you know, it's this way, but maybe next time you say, okay, I'm just going to shoot here. But it makes more sense to shoot one above or one below, because the ship is one piece, not two pieces. So in all likelihood, anybody who's ever played this game is going to go either once they've hit one, they're either going to go here because it's beside it, here because it's beside it, or here because it's beside it. But without that piece of data, you could make a plan and you're doing your shooting here and here and here and here and here. Without that one piece of data, you can't know what your next step is. And this is the whole point, is most smart planning, you plan it to death with a lack of objective data from the real world, from the universe, to be able to plan your next step. So you can't plan a project from start to finish unless you've done that exact project or one extremely similar to it. That's ridiculous. That's unscientific. So you got your point of data that says you should shoot here, here, or here, but you don't know that until you get the hit on A5. So really that's what it is. You know your destination. In this case, your destination is to kill your opponent, to hit their ships. You finally made a shot after making quite a few misses here. You got a hit. So what do? You shoot next to that. You can't know what that point is. You can't know your next action until you have objective data to verify that you're going in the right direction, that you're on the right trajectory towards your end goal, whether it's killing ships in a game, making $1 million, getting fit. You need to know your destination. You need to know your next step, and anything else in most cases, not all cases, but in most cases, is a waste of time where you could be gathering real data, real information from empirical information that's derived from the real world to teach you what your next step should be. And your next step becomes immediately obvious. It's the same in this goal setting that I'm talking about. Your next step is often, I don't remember the last time, for the most part. I'm doing it with the web browser stuff and the web page stuff because I don't know anything about it. It's brand new to me. But the vast majority of the time, I can go months or years at a time where I don't need to say, oh, what is my next step? I already know what my next step is because I finished the last step. And oftentimes finishing that step makes the next step obvious without overtly planning it. So anytime you spend planning in the absence of data, you are just making a guess, an uneducated, uninformed guess. So when you're doing that for 2021, you want to achieve your goals, know where you want to go, know your next action. Your next action, because visualizing it means fuck all if you don't do anything about it. Know where you want to go, know your next step, and take that. Not until T, time bound, is in a SMART goal, which is another reason they're actually stupid. It's not, shouldn't be time bound, but time boxed. That is a certain amount of time each day, each week, each month, but ideally every fucking day, because that's what works best in terms of behavior formation, is to do it every day for a set period of time. And if you achieve that period of time working at your maximal effort and ability, you have achieved your goal for that day. Time bound, nobody knows when something's finished until you're finished, because you don't have the data to really make that estimation, unless of course you've done a highly analogous or an identical project. And for most people, that's not the case. It's something new that they want to do. So your end destination, your next step, that's all you need to do. And then you need to take action, ideally every fucking day. Bye for now. My name is Tim B. Green. This was Crush It Club, episode 8.